guys, Jimbo here, the driving test guy in New South Wales, helping you pass your New South Wales driving test first go, hopefully. First of all, I want to say thank you to those who have financially supported this channel by using the Buy Me a Coffee link. Very, very appreciated. And if any others of you want to also say thank you with the Buy Me a Coffee link, please do. The link is down below. Very much appreciated. Okay, folks, this is another driving test tip video, and this is about reversing head checks. On the New South Wales driving test, there's really three main places you may have to reverse, and you will need to do specific head checks for that. On the reverse parallel park, three-point turn, and maybe reversing out of the test center car park. Okay, now, I break the reverse head checks into two components. It's the check you do before reversing, the check you do while reversing. Now, the check you do before reversing is what I'm gonna call the 360 degree check. Okay, so you put the car in reverse. Before you back up, you look around the vehicle. Do your right shoulder, mirrors, left shoulder, right around the vehicle. That's why I call it the 360 degree check. Now, once you're happy there's no one in your way, the second check is when you're actually moving. Now, before you move, you need to put your eyes out the back window. You can't just rely on mirrors or the camera anymore. You've got to look out the back window and start moving. Once you start moving though, you can refer to other places. You can refer to your mirrors, you can refer to your camera, or you can refer out the front how your angle's going, but you've got to keep checking the back window regularly, and that's what they're marking. So, two components, the check you do before reversing, what I call the 360, and then the check you do while reversing, looking out the back regularly, but you can refer to the mirrors and the camera. Okay, so let's go out and do a reverse park, three-point turn, and reverse out of a car park and show you these checks.
Okay, so the first reversing scenario is reversing out of a 90 degree car park. The situation might be that you had elected to start your driving test nosed in. That means you'll have to start the test by backing out.
Okay, so we're in the 90 degree car park. We started the car, we're in reverse. Now, before you back out of the 90 degree car park, again, we're gonna do our 360 degree check. Check right around the vehicle, right shoulder, right around left shoulder, looking right around the vehicle. If you're happy no one's there, then we still have to look out the back window. Look out the back window, but then start referring again other places, but check the back. Refer other places, because cars can still be coming side to side. Check the back still. Check around the car, check out the back, check around the car, check out the back. I can use a camera if I want. Check the back, check around. Long as you just keep checking out the back window while you're reversing, and you'll satisfy the reverse head checks for the driving test.
Okay, so the second scenario where you'll be required to do reversing on the New South Wales driving test is a three-point turn. So we've pulled over, mirror indicates shoulder, and there's really one point we need to do the reversing. It's once we've head to the other side, we need to reverse. So we've got the indicator, check our shoulder, we head over to the other side. Now, this is the point where we're gonna need to do some reverse checks.
Now, this is the moment we put in reverse. This is where we do the 360 degree check. A check around the car, up and down the road, right around the vehicle to make sure no one's there. Now, the second bit is when reversing. We look out the back window and we refer to other places. Look out the back window, refer to other places. Look out the back window, refer to other places. Okay? Pop it in the drive, check up and down the road, and off we go.
Okay, so our third and last scenario that requires reversing is the reverse parallel park.
Pop it in reverse. Now again, before reversing, we do the 360 degree check. We check around the vehicle, all the mirrors, both blind spots, right around the vehicle to make sure nobody's in the way. Now the second part is, when you actually start reversing, you look out the back window. Once you start reversing, look out the back, you can then refer to other places. I can refer to my mirror, I can refer to the camera, but I've got to keep checking the back window while reversing. That's what they mark. You've got to keep remembering to check the back window. So I can check my angle, but I check the back window. I check my mirrors again, I check my back window. I check my mirrors, I check the back window. Check the back window, check the mirrors, check the back window, and then we bring it home. Okay, folks, so a question I always get asked with reversing, can you use your reverse camera? Okay, yes you can, but you can only refer to it. You still need to check the back window. It's the rear window that the examiner's marking. You can refer to it, like you can refer to your side mirrors. Okay, guys, that's it for today. The tip for reverse head checks. Two parts to that, 360 before you reverse and regularly looking out the back window while reversing. Okay, folks, if you are new to the channel, please press the subscribe button and the notification bell. If you like the video, please press the like button. And if you are a viewer and I have saved you hundreds of dollars and made getting your license or passing the test a lot more easier for you, please consider buying me a virtual coffee. The link is in the description. Okay, folks, that's it. The most important thing is, though, always remember, stay safe.